Puffin Group, welcome to day two. I'm going to go over your activities for today. So today you're going to work on completing the worksheets below, using the pictures from your living versus non-living sort yesterday to write a full list. So whether you put these on paper, you just have them in a baggie, or you find things on your own to use, you can use that for this activity. You're going to read for 20 minutes and complete the reading log. Do a 10-minute reading activity, a 10-minute math activity, 30 minutes of Spanish, 30 minutes of Mandarin, and then get some fresh air and exercise. So I'm going to get into your work for today. Our first activity has to do with spring words, okay? So you have this word bank picture right here. So we have spring, butterfly, caterpillar, chrysalis, pond, tadpole, frog, bud, which is a small plant, blossom, flower, duck, and duckling, which are the baby ducks here. So you're going to use this sheet to complete this activity right here. I can write April words. So you're going to look at the word bank above and see that this is a chrysalis. And you're going to write the word chrysalis here. And you're going to do that for each of these flowers. If you have space, write them more than once. And then you're going to choose one of the words. Doesn't matter which one, to write a sentence with. So I might see right here there's a frog, and I could write the frog jumped. I would make sure my T in the is capitalized because it's the first letter in my sentence, and I'd put a period at the end. And then you're going to pick another one from above to also do the same thing. Like maybe you're going to use butterfly. The butterfly flew away, and put a period at the end. And then you have this right here. Now this is a mix of math and reading. So I wanna see how well you're able to read your number names. So we have the number 8 here, but we have to find it in word form on this side and draw a line in between. So 8, I know it ends in a T. And so I can see this one right here ends in a T. Now we have 8, good. So I'm gonna go like this and draw my line and connect them. So this is the number in number form, and this is it in word form. So we have 8 and 8, and I would draw a straight line in between to connect those two words. Okay. Then you're going to use your activity from yesterday, where you were sorting living things versus non-living things to create these lists here. Now, if you lost some of your cards, it's okay, because I know you guys can start to figure out what things are living. So you might write human, giraffe, lion on this side, and you're going to write 8 things that are living, and you're going to write 8 things that are non-living, like magnet, TV, bed, and you're going to create 2 different lists of things that are living versus things that are non-living. And that's your work for today. I know you guys will all work hard and work well with your parents, and I can't wait to see what you come up with. Have a great day.